Well, I'm Daniel, and welcome to the Emunah Project. We're here at the Emunah Project, are continuing in our series of videos with respect to inspiration, information, education, guidance, advice. And as is usual, I am struck by the unusual phrasings in the Torah. And this is something that that an observant Jew repeats twice a day when he recites the Shema. Is don't go achare levavchem v'achare enehem. Don't go after your heart and after your eyes, for they will deceive you. And it seems to me that the order is reversed. To go after your heart and after your eyes. It seems to me that the natural order of things is you see something that tempts you, and then your heart desires it. But no. In this pasuk, in the book of Numbers, chapter 15, verse 39, it's reversed. Don't go achre levavchem, a lev is a heart. Don't go achre levavchem and achre nehem. Don't go after the heart and don't go after the eyes. Harav Yehuda Leib Fine was giving a lecture with respect to tznias, a modest dress. As you know, Orthodox Jews dress modestly, not in provocative colors or provocative cuts of clothing. Skirts tend to be at least 3 inches below the knee. Collarbones are not seen. Sleeves are like 3/4 length. And modest behavior. And it goes both ways, men and women. So getting to this posuk, Achre levavchem v'achre enehem. Rav Fine was saying that in the situation of immodest dress, it's reversed. The person's heart, for reasons of either of insecurity or being swayed and tempted by the environment, by fashion, it's the heart that causes the person to dress immodestly, provocatively. And then it's the eyes that follow. We should keep this in mind. I wish more Christian missionaries kept this in mind. If I had a buck for every time I had some Christian missionary says, "Oh well, you know, what does your heart tell you?" I says, "What do you say? What does your heart tell you? The Torah itself says, don't follow your heart. So why are you telling people to follow their heart?" Again, baffles me. Just baffles me. But this is the. This is the society in which we live. This is the world in which we live. And as I've said in previous videos, we have to be constantly aware of our environment because of the temptation to follow the environment, when in Rome, do as the Romans, or the possibility of the environment affecting us in a bad way, corrupting us. We're going to be doing more videos along these lines. Please come back. Please watch. Please learn. And until next time, on behalf of the Emunah Project, I'm Daniel, and thank you so much.